Okay, so this is Arachnophobia for the Amiga. Very haunting title screen. So a remarkably aggressive and extremely poisonous spider is discovered in a remote South American rainforest. Was that Dilbert McGlintock welcomes you as a proud member of the. Oh, okay. Story's rolling. Escapes and mates with a local queen spider, creating an army of deadly offspring. Oh, okay. What's going on here then? Okay, so we're controlling it, but only when it goes on the road. So for some reason it's auto moving. Is it fire to dis Wait, is fire to time to fumigate? Okay. Interesting. Can we only fire straight ahead? Or do you have to jump on the spiders? Oh, I don't like the look of our. You see our portrait in the bottom middle, we're slowly getting more. Turning grey. Oh, here. Oh, he's dead. That was a good game. Oh my goodness. Yikes. That is definitely a picture.
Time to fumigate.
Okay, so it does actually work. You just sort of you have to move whilst aiming down. Okay. What is that with those sound effects? Oh, it jumped. Okay, so I'm guessing your objective is to rid the all the houses of the spiders, and then you automatically. Is it up to go up the stairs? It should be up. Yes, it is. Look, don't retreat. I mean, oh. How big is this house? Or maybe it's like an apartment, I don't know. Okay, why is our picture flickering?
Another satisfied customer.
Okay, that's kind of cool, I guess. I don't know. I'm glad I didn't. I was expecting it to be like some kind of graphic adventure and be like very, very complicated. Oh, hello. Was that the bomb? Whatever it was effective. Oh. Okay, can't get through the web. Oh, no, we've had enough of that one. Let's go to another house. Let's go back to this one. Oh, or that one. Okay, sure.
Too quick for you. Another satisfied customer.
So, what's the objective here? Is it just to riddle the spiders off every single house and apartment? And that's it. I should look at the manual. But so far, we've got everything down. Yeah, that counts as a bomb. Does that just, yeah, clears everyone out?
Too quick for you. Too quick for you. Too quick for you. The egg sack.
Okay, so still more of the blight is about. Oh, okay, fair enough. Still a few more.
Too quick for you. Preventative fumigation.
When they say pro-sensitive fumigation,
bug off. The egg sack. The queen.
Oh, wow. Okay. Oh wow, just an insta kill that one, pretty much. Can you even kill the queen? Also, maybe I should have saved it. Just putting it out there. Okay, what house haven't we visited? This one?
Time to fumigate. On a tuffet. On a tuffet. The egg sack. Another satisfied customer. On a tuffet.
I don't mean to do that game.
No! On a toughie. Sit on a toughie. Sit on a toughie.
Okay, let's see if there is a manual about. I assume that he's just driving back and forth. Yeah. Okay. Is there anything about this? So this was done in 1991, so fairly old game. Oh, here we go. Know your enemy. So we've got soldier spiders, queen spiders, and South American spider. And that is on page. Oh, they're on page 5. The colourful markings on her leg and abdomen disguise the deadly serious nature of this mama. She is highly aggressive and strangely intelligent, actually seeking out human prey. Tough as nails, she needs many strong doses of, it's called Toxi-Max insecticide before expiring. Bug bombs will temporarily slow her down, giving you the opportunity to asphyxiate her with multiple shots, or completely toast her with the hot flame of an ignited aerosol can. Two bites from this femme fatale and you're a proverbial notch in her belt. Take my advice, don't get close enough to see the whites of her eyes. Especially since she doesn't have any. And the south. So there's aerosol flamethrowers as well. And I think we've come across those, but I'm not sure how to use it. And then there's the South American spider is twice as large as the queen spider. The South American is also twice as deadly. This monster mamba will succumb only to an outrageous exposure of spray and insecticide. Keep pumping the stuff till this creature cooks to a crisp. Don't forget, this is the lion of the arachnid world. Before it met man, it had no predators. Now look out, sucker. The warning applies to you as well as the spider. One most singular, exquisite bite will drop you flat dead. Cool, that's something to look forward to. It's quite a cheerful, wholesome game on the whole. Oh, here we go, some controls here. Can use the keypad as well. So drop bug bomb with spacebar. Oh, you can jump in the game as well. Push joystick up and then press joystick. Oh, and then press the joystick button. Okay. Doesn't mention about using the flame thrower though. Maybe we haven't picked that up. Okay, whatever. Let's continue on. We'll run out a few of this rates. So we go to the one on the bottom right, perhaps. Oh yeah, we did actually do this before, didn't we? Not much of a jump though, but it might be necessary in some scenarios. Oh, wow. Didn't quite see that. Curse you, four-screen beach ball.
Another satisfied customer. Yeah.
bit, nab the health. Oh. That's a bit weird. By collecting the first aid kit, only then we were able to proceed. That was a bit weird.
Another satisfied customer.
Do a quick save.
The cavalry has arrived.
Oh, okay. We've got the flamethrower for the first time. Nice. I mean, so it certainly makes life a little bit easier. Remember, guys, solve your problems with fire. I'm guessing it doesn't last. I'm guessing it sort of resets back to normal when we go to another house. Go to this one. Yeah, a shame. But I guess it would have been too easy otherwise. Got 6 bombs as well.
Bug off. satisfied customer. Bug off. Another satisfied customer. On a tuffet. The egg sack. Another satisfied customer. satisfied customer.
Okay, so how many we've got left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Wonder why one of the houses is hidden amidst a whole bunch of trees. Sorry, 7. 7, 7. I must admit, I did like the gimmick at the start, but it seems like a lot of these houses, a lot of the levels are very, I don't know, they get very kind of repetitive. It was kind of intriguing seeing the Queen Bee for the, the Queen Spider for the first time. So that will probably be a challenge whenever we do face up with her next. Oh, that wasn't... Okay, that was different. I think we had to shake off the spider by wiggling the joystick, so in that case, I was like pressing the left and right arrow. That was not pleasant.
Another satisfied customer. Too quick for you. Too quick for you. Too quick for you. Too quick for you. The egg sack. Too quick for you.
Uh-oh. Will it chase me? It's not good. Yeah, that is not easy. I mean, the rest of it was pretty much a cakewalk, but as soon as you meet up with something a little bit different, it really, yeah, really sort of ups the, just the difficulty of it all. Now, where did I last leave I save. Okay, there. Can I actually aim down there and get the...
Another satisfied customer. On a tough it. Sit on a tough it.
Oh, he's dead. Oh, there we go.
And we're good. On to the next town.
Town of Konamiya praises Delbert for his heroic deeds. On to the next town, did he say? Oh, okay. I thought that first map was the whole game. Just goes to show how naive I am. Okay. We are about to die. So let's go to this tall building. Why not?
Time to fumigate. Bug off.
Okay, that's the flamethrower again. Oh no, it's not. Never mind. Thought it was. Not a good time to sneeze, Rob. It's even worse when even worse when it turned out to be a full sneeze. God, that's I really hate that. I really, yeah, that's the one thing I hate when streaming. That just like just immediately hit feeling a very, very, very loud sneeze. Especially with this game, because if I execute that, it would scare off lots of people, and I'd probably die in the game as well. Whoops. No, I didn't want to retreat.
Another satisfied customer.
What's going on there? Is that just like luggage in the foreground? It's kind of scummy, but I think I'll let the game off for hiding spiders in the foreground. Because it's, yeah, just for the scare appeal. I think the game would benefit if it had more like shocking moments like that. If like what well, like right now, like say a spider emerges from the toilet or the plant pot, that'd be kind of cool. Just make the character extra paranoid. Didn't mean to run off scared. I can now definitely feel that sneeze. Okay, so about that.
satisfied customer.
Okay, probably got just enough time for one more house to visit. Maybe that little dinky yellow one over there? Oh, hidden foreground spiders, how dare. Suppose we can jump over them, but our jump is so puny. Hey Bez, how's it going? Hopefully as well. Yeah, it's a new one on me. Never experienced this one. Arachnophobia. No, we just Cammy and Shep were talking about spiders and stuff, and it led to Trapshot choosing Arachnophobia as this game. It's okay. I do like the idea. I've never seen a game quite like this before. Once you get over, you know, like the horrific death game over screen, I feel that a lot of the levels are largely the same, with the exception of course, the we had a queen spider that attacked us. That was a bit ruthless. But yeah. I think it would be better if it had more sort of scenarios. Like there were some spiders that fell off the floor onto your face, which was quite a bit of shock. It needs a bit more shock value to it. Needs a few, like, I don't mind having the same kind of enemy, but they could do so much with it. They could have like lots of ambush attacks and things like that. Having said that, that could well happen. I face another queen spider. Not this time.
Another satisfied customer.
Okay, a few more minutes. This is definitely the last house we are checking out. So let's visit this one. Oh, here we go. Someone's crying for help. Now, yeah, truth be told, I don't think we ventured too much in this game, because I thought the one load of houses that we went through, I thought that was just that part of the game, but turns out there are other towns to fumigate. Whoops. And yeah, I mean, the game isn't terribly easy either, even though it is kind of predictable now. Mostly predictable. I know as soon as I'm going to say that, I'm going to fall into another trap. Oh, here we go. Okay, that was a guy. Yeah, had to be.
Sit on it, though.
Nope, just an empty room. Okay. Okay, the bugger meter isn't going too crazy. I'm here, okay. I think these are the last ones? Nope, still more. Next room. More spiders? Okay. Running a little low on spray as well. That hasn't happened at the moment.
Preventative fumigation.
Okay, I was just in the nick of time. Maybe one more house. I don't know. We'll play for a tiny bit longer. Ah, here we go. We got these annoying ceiling spiders. Wow. Okay, that's a bit cruel. Oh, and we're dead. Okay, well, I was gonna say we're gonna wrap things up anyway, so what a lovely way to end the game with a lovely a lovely beautiful game over screen. We did however kill 304 spiders, and we killed those in 40 minutes, so that's not too bad. But yeah, even if we weren't playing it on Amiga Live, even if we didn't have save states, it does allow a save feature as well, which is pretty cool. So maybe it's a pretty big game then. I don't know. There might be maybe there's just 3 towns to visit, maybe there's 10, who knows. But they certainly did, didn't they? Yeah, they love putting effort into the most grotesque and revolting screens of all time. Absolutely. So, that is the end of the video. First impressions, I know I've said this a couple of times, I think it needs a few more shocking ambushes, like spiders just appearing out of baths, or just like a massive spider just like stalking you, just, you know, lots of other things as well. But on the other hand, I haven't seen through the whole game. I might have even just explored a small portion of it, so maybe that sort of stuff already happens. But yeah, the beginning, once you got into it, it was kind of mundane. There wasn't really much to do except, you know, go through all the unexplored areas and fumigate the spiders there. But yeah, a very original game. Never seen anything like this before. So yeah, take that for what it's worth.